Now, before moving on with the important questions on calcium, let us see the chemistry of calcium. Now, the total body calcium, okay, I'm writing here, the total body calcium is about 1 to 1.5 kg. And in this 1 to 1.5 kg, 99%, okay, it is present in our bones and teeth, and the remaining 1%, it is present in our body fluids and tissues. Okay, so this is about the basic. Now moving on with the sources of calcium, mainly the milk and dairy products. Okay, now sources of calcium, mainly the milk and dairy products. Okay, and apart from that, you can also add egg yolk, fish, and then beans. Okay, next, the RDA, the recommended daily allowance of calcium, is for adults, it is present for adults. We need 500 mg per day. For children, we need a little more, 1200 milligram per day. And in pregnancy, as well as in lactation, we need 1500 mg per day. Now the absorption of calcium is important. Okay, you have to read about it. Let me just discuss about it. The absorption of calcium, the site of absorption of calcium, okay, is first part and second part of duodenum. First you write that, first and second part of duodenum. Okay, here the calcium is absorbed against the concentration gradient, and it also requires energy as well as a carrier protein. That point you have to write. Now, what are the factors affecting the absorption? That is, first we'll discuss what are the factors which increases the absorption. Okay, mainly the calcitriol. First point you have to write about calcitriol. Next, the PTH, that is parathyroid hormone. Third point, acidity, and the fourth point is the amino acids, mainly the lysine and arginine. Okay, amino acids, mainly the lysine and arginine. Now, what are the factors which decrease the absorption rate? That we'll be discussing now. First important point you have to write is the phytates. Next, oxalates. Okay. They can ask you in one more question about the decrease in absorption rate. They can give you the options among this, and they can give one option among this, then select the right answer. Okay, so phytates, oxalates, and free fatty acids. Okay, that is the calcium free fatty acids, and then the high dietary fiber are the things which is going to decrease the absorption of calcium. Now, the most important 5-mark question they are going to ask you is, what are the functions of calcium? The biochemical functions of calcium can be asked as a 5-mark question. Okay, let us discuss that. Let me write here. Now, the biochemical functions of calcium. First, it is going to help in the mineralization of bone and teeth. So you know 99% of the total body calcium is present in the bones and teeth. So bone is nothing but a mineralized connective tissue and also contains a organic, that is a collagen protein, as well as the inorganic, that is the mineral component. Okay, that point you have to write. Apart from that, you can also write about the coagulation. The next important function is the coagulation of blood. Remember, calcium is factor 4 in the coagulation cascade. Okay, the prothrombin, that is the factor 2, let me write here, the prothrombin, what is the factor 2, it contains mainly GLA, that is the gamma carboxyglutamate residues. So this calcium is going to form a bridge between the GLA residues of the prothrombin and the membrane phospholipids of the platelets. Okay, so I'm talking about the calcium is nothing but the factor 4 in the coagulation cascade. Now here I'm talking about the prothrombin, which is the factor 2, and it contains GLA, means what? The gamma carboxyglutamate residues, and this calcium is going to form a bridge between the GLA residues of the prothrombin as well as the membrane phospholipids of the platelets. That point you have to include. Now the next important thing is activation of enzymes. So here you have to include the word calmodulin. Remember, calmodulin is nothing but a calcium binding regulatory protein, and it is said that the calmodulin can bind with four calcium ions. Now let us see the mechanism of action of calcium. Remember, we have calcium, it is going to bind with calmodulin. And now what happens is, it's going to form calcium bound calmodulin, right? Now this calcium bound calmodulin is going to activate kinase into active kinase. Now this active kinase is going to make the enzyme, okay, it's going to make the enzyme into phosphorylated enzyme. Okay, so we have made it as phosphorylated enzyme, and this phosphorylated enzyme is going to cause a biological effect, right? So this is about the mechanism of action of calcium, right? Now apart from that, we can also include nerves. Okay, so in nerve what happens is, calcium is necessary for the transmission of the nerve impulses from the presynaptic to postsynaptic. Okay, so I'm saying the calcium is necessary for the transmission of nerves from what? From presynaptic to postsynaptic. Next important point is secretion of hormones. So here you write about this calcium is going to mediate a secretion of insulin, parathyroid hormone, calcitonin and vasopressin from the cells. That point you have to write down. Let's turn the page and write and see about any other functions are there for calcium. Now here, so what, which point was before? Fifth point. Now let us write sixth point, that the second messenger in signal transduction, okay, it is going to act as a second messenger in signal transduction. So here the calcium as well as cyclic AMP, okay, they are going to be acting as a second messengers of different hormones. So one example I can say, that is the glucagon. Okay, can I give the example? That is glucagon. So here the calcium is used as a second messenger in systems which is involving the G proteins and inositol triphosphate. Okay, so here the calcium and cyclic AMP, they are the second messengers at different hormones. One kind of example is glucagon. Okay, next important point is in myocardium. So in myocardium, the most important point you have to talk about is in myocardium, that is the calcium that is going to prolong systole. Again, asking one more question, it is going to prolong systole. Okay, so in hypercalcemia, cardiac arrest is seen in systole. That point you can remember. Now, when calcium is administered intravenously, it must be given very slowly. Why? Because of this reason. Okay, in hypercalcemia, the cardiac arrest is seen in the systole. That point you can include. Okay. Now, let us see about PTH, that is parathyroid hormone, or else paroth hormone. Okay, so this paroth hormone, it is secreted by chief cells of parathyroid. They are secreted by the chief cells of parathyroid. This is the first point you are going to write. And the release of PTH, it is mediated by cyclic AMP. Okay, we have to discuss in three important side of action, that is bone, kidney, and then in intestine. So all these three actions of PTH, it is going to increase the serum calcium level. Okay, now in bone, what happens is, let us discuss what happens in bone. Now in bone, the PTH will cause demineralization or decalcification. That is the first point you have to write. It's going to cause demineralization or decalcification. That is the first point. Next point is, it is going to induce, pyrophosphatase. Okay, it is going to induce pyrophosphatase in the osteoclast. That is the second point you are going to write. And these number of osteoclasts can also be increased. Okay, now this osteoclast, it is going to release lactate. It is going to release lactate, and that will cause solubilization of the calcium. Okay, so this you are going to write in the bone. That is the action on bone. Now in kidney, this PTH is going to have a direct action. That is, it is going to decrease the renal excretion of calcium. It's going to, decrease the renal excretion of calcium, mainly by increasing the reabsorption of calcium from distal tubules, and also it is also going to increase the phosphate excretion. So these two important points you can write down in action on kidney. Okay, next on in the intestine. So in intestine, actually PTH, it is going to stimulate, so let us write in a flow chart how it is going to increase the calcium level in blood. Okay, first it is going to stimulate the one hydroxylation, 25 cholecalciferol. Okay, so one hydroxylation, 25 cholecalciferol. That is going to cause calcitriol. It's going to form calcitriol. Okay, so we have found calcitriol, and this calcitriol, it is going to induce the synthesis of calbindin. Now this calbindin, let me write it here. Now this calbindin, it is going to induce the, it's going to increase the calcium absorption from intestine, we have discussed already, and thereby it is going to increase the calcium level in blood. This again, write down. Next important point is about calcitonin. Remember, calcitonin, it is secreted by parafollicular cells of thyroid. That point you have to write down if they ask you about calcitonin. So parafollicular cells of thyroid. Now this calcitonin, it is going to promote calcification by increasing the activity of osteoblasts, right? And it is also going to decrease the bone resorption. That point again, write down. In calcitonin, it is also going to increase the excretion of calcium in urine, right? And overall, it is going to decrease the blood calcium level. Decrease the blood calcium level, right? This is about the calcitonin, right? Now let's see the deficiency mechanisms. First we'll talk about the hypercalcemia. Okay, first we'll talk about hypercalcemia. The causes of hypercalcemia is very important for the chart questions, so let us focus on that. Causes of hypercalcemia. First important point you have to write down is, it is hyperparathyroidism. Okay. So first is hyperparathyroidism. So in hyperparathyroidism, it is characterized by increase in the serum calcium. Okay, let's write down, increase in serum calcium, decrease in serum phosphate, and increase in the alkaline phosphatase activity. These 3 points you have to remember for biochemical investigations. Okay. So increase in serum calcium, decrease in serum phosphate, and increase in the alkaline phosphatase. Okay. Now apart from that, we can also include multiple myeloma, the causes of hypercalcemia, myeloma, and you can also include Paget's disease, and then secondary bone cancer, that you can include in the hypercalcemia. Now let us see the clinical features of hypercalcemia. First, on neurological symptoms, you get depression. Remember it as DCI, depression, confusion, and irritability. Okay, next is you get a generalized muscle weakness. Okay, next, in GIT you get AANV, that is anorexia, abdominal pain, nausea, and then vomiting. And in CVS you get cardiac arrhythmias. Okay, so I'm going a little fast because this is just clinical features, right? Now in hypocalcemia, let's discuss about hypocalcemia. So you have to remember them for chart questions. Okay, now in hypocalcemia, remember the serum calcium level is less than 8.8 mg per dl, you get as hypocalcemia. But remember, when the serum calcium level is less than 7 mg per dl, you get a condition called as tetany. We'll discuss the clinical features of tetany also. Okay, now let us discuss the causes of hypocalcemia, right? First, the accidental surgical removal of parathyroid. Next, the most important point is pseudo hypoparathyroidism, that is lack of the end organ response. Okay, so let us write that, pseudo hypoparathyroidism. Next, renal disease. Next, liver disease. Next will be vitamin D deficiency. That you can add down, right? Apart from that, you can also add up with osteoporosis, renal rickets, etc. Now let us see the clinical features of tetany. Okay, first you get the point as neuromuscular irritability. Okay, first you get neuromuscular irritability. Apart from that, you get spasms, that is mainly the laryngeal spasm can cause death. Okay, so you get spasms. Next, convulsions, and then muscular cramps. Okay, and in ECG changes, mainly the QT interval will be increased. Okay, so this is about the deficiency of calcium. So when you are studying about calcium, first you move on with the chemistry, then the absorption can be asked in 1 mark question or else in 5 mark question. Okay, and you read about the biochemical functions of calcium, and then the deficiency, meaning the hypercalcemia, hypocalcemia, and tetany for chart questions. Thank you. Don't forget to subscribe. Have a nice day. Thank you.